Hi, I'm Keith with Danfoss Food Retail Controls, and today's video will be on building a calculation for the system manager.
Thanks, Keith. Calculations can be set up locally at the 800 controller or using a remote connection. Today we'll show you how to set up calculations using the RMT software. To program a calculation in RMT, go to Configuration, Control, Miscellaneous, and Calculations. From here, double-click on New Calc to choose your calculation number. And then from there, you double-click into the calculation that you've just created. So the general layout of a calculation has the units, which will be the output of your calculation, the calculation style, like a clone, generic, or cut-in, cut-out, and then you have your inputs in the top half and your outputs in the bottom half. So the way that it works, your inputs will be used, and then based on the logic statement down in the bottom, you'll result whatever the first true line of the calculation is. So for the first example, we're going to set it to SI degrees F with a clone type calculation, and I'll label this as outside air temp clone. From here, we choose the input sensor that we want to clone, in this case the outside temperature, and then you can see down in the output the first logic statement is a true type, which means that we'll always evaluate as true, and therefore we output that particular result. So here we have a clone of the outside temperature, it evaluates as true, and therefore outputs the sensor input 1, which is our sensor clone. And then from here we can go over to the miscellaneous section and the sensor inputs, which we have created, and I already labeled this as the outside copy. And then we choose that board and point to look at the calculated section and choose calculation 1, which is a clone of the outside temperature. The second type of calculation we'll go over is a cut-in, cut-out type. So as you can see, this is my calculation 2. The output will be an on-off input, so this is either true or false. In our case, let's have a look at the suction temperature, and we would compare that to two particular values. So if the suction temperature was over 30 degrees or below 15 degrees, then this calculation would become true. So as you can see down in the bottom part, if the sensor input 1, which is the suction temperature, is greater than number 2, which is 30 degrees, then this calculation will evaluate as on. If the input, which is the suction temperature, is less than number 3, which is 15 degrees, then the result will be off. So it's important that you order these outputs in the correct order, because the first one that evaluates as true, you will get that result and the calculation will end. The next type of calculation is the generic type. So as you can see, when we changed from cut-in, cut-out to a generic type, we lost all of our inputs. So make sure you set your calculation style before you start building the calculation. So from here, if we want to add a new input, then you press to insert new line and choose your data point type. You can choose anything from a relay output, on-off input, variable outputs, and various other options. So from here, you choose whichever input you want to look at and build your calculation. And like I said before, the calculation will end as soon as the first logic statement evaluates as true. So if relay 1 is true, the result of this calculation will be off. But if relay 1 is not true or is not on, we go down to the next line, which is true. And this is sort of a catch-all or an else-if statement. So from here, the result would be on, and this calculation would default to on if we don't have a signal from relay 1. If you click into that calculation down at the bottom, you can see you can make different comparisons, and that will allow you to build your logic statements. And that's how you build a Danfoss calculation.
For more information on this topic, see the description below. And for more videos like this, visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US, and thank you for watching.